Now, with this in place, now here comes the really interesting question. It's assignment number two. And again, it's a programming assignment. Feel free to skip. Now that we have a function flip that gives me this list of 1,000 outcomes from which I can now derive things like the mean, run this thing itself 1,000 times. And each time you get a different mean. So it's mean 0, mean 1, and so on, all the way to mean 999. And these means are continuous values, obviously, between 0 and 1. I'm giving the same function as before, mean, variance, standard deviation, and flip. And as I scroll down, I find this function sample. And I want you to put in code over here so that when I sample with the same n, I run the flip experiment 1,000 times. And every single time I compute the mean. And now I assemble a list of all the means into this thing called outcomes. The means will be continuous. I can do a history plot. It'll be better with many bins. So this notation over here gives me 30 bins. And to give you a feel for what to expect, this is a typical histogram I get out as a result. It's really beautiful. If I increase n to 2,000, I get this histogram over here. Apologize, the numbers aren't a little legible over here. But the center of it is 0.5, and it falls off to smaller numbers to the left or to the right. You can think of this as a distribution over the means outcomes of large numbers of coin flips, and has an interesting shape. So go ahead and program it and see if you can reproduce these results.